college. And I was never really an exceptional student. My marks were always just enough to not explain them to my parents, or just enough to pass exams like chemistry, or just enough to get to a decent college, or just enough to get a job. I didn't enjoy going to college. So about 5 years ago, when I started working in skills in education, a lot of my friends asked me why. And I said, because I dislike the process so much that I really want to do something about it. This is Nisha. We trained Nisha in early 2016. She comes from a very simple family from this village called Peepli in Haryana. Her father is a tempo driver. And under a lot of family pressure, at the age of 17, Nisha had to get married. But she made her dad promise that before he sends her away to her husband's house, he will let her attend college. And she did. She used to travel every day 50 kilometers to Ambala, to this college called Gandhi Memorial National College, which is where we met her and started working with her to help her achieve her dreams. Like Nisha, there are a few thousand stories of courage and circumstance that we hear from our students every day. There are students like Meenakshi, who could not afford to go to college, so she had to work in the college library to, you know, pay for her train fare every day from Saharanpur in UP and Yamunanagar in Haryana. Or students like Saurabh, who had to, you know, earn money for his family because his father, an auto rickshaw driver, got into an unfortunate accident and was bedridden. Or Nitin, who could not attend his own mother's funeral because someone had to run the dhaba. They've all been brilliant students. They come from daily wage earning families. A lot of them are first generation college goers. About 70% of our students come from low income households. And the fact that these students don't come from affluent households or top colleges or big cities doesn't only make a difference to their exposure or the quality of their education, it also makes a massive difference to the career options and opportunities that they have at the end of their college. There are about 25 million students who come out of higher education in India every year, and only roughly about half of them are employable. They're all victims of education that has not really adapted itself to 21st century careers. And, you know, there's always a lot of conversation around we need to, you know, change education or we need an overhaul in education, but there's still a lack of accountability. And when skill development started becoming a household term about 8 years ago, the idea was to bridge this gap of accountability. But by the end of 2016, there were about 1.7 million students who were trained under various government programs, and only 5% of them got jobs. So when we started working on this vision of trying to build careers for our students, we want to understand where they come from, what their dreams are, and what's stopping them. What we learned was that our students have been boxed into this way of thinking that limits their options to, you know, certain tried and tested formulae like banking or government jobs or IT. You know, they are still gauging their ability to do something based on their marks in the 5 or 8 subjects that are on their report card. And they know very little about 21st century careers and the corresponding skills that they need. The education system has made them so used to spoon feeding that they are not motivated to look at what's really happening in the real world. So our idea was to build a solution that actually makes a difference at scale. We had to keep in mind the various failures of different policies that had come into the market. We had to keep in mind the limitations of technology-based models that were promising single-digit completion rates and somehow recreating that problem of accountability. And we built a hybrid blended learning model that combines the strength and familiarity of classrooms and uses mobile phones of students for the engagement that it can offer. Using technology, we've been able to standardize quality for our remotest centers. We've been able to customize the learning journeys of our students who come from different backgrounds. Their starting points are different. We've been able to make our programs more affordable for our students, and more students can, as a result, afford it. And our trainers are looking at dashboards that, you know, give them data from the classrooms as well as the apps that students are using to identify students who either need a pat on their back or need some extra help. We've leveraged technology in a big way for the large problems that our students are facing, but it hasn't been the solution. You know, we've had to fulfill each promise we made to each of our students by giving them access to a facilitator who either nudges them sometimes or incentivizes them to pick up their phone and use it for, you know, learning and not just for social media. You know, our trainers are constantly telling them about the different careers that are available for them. And they're also trying to build skills like critical thinking and problem solving. A lot of our students need to understand different ideas that we keep thinking about, like artificial intelligence or self-driving cars or virtual reality. So we are talking to them about these ideas, ideas that sometimes for them are, they sound a little out of reach, or some of these ideas are actually unheard of. And by getting them into the classroom every once in a while, we are really addressing the problem of students dropping out of the education system. So far, we've trained about 13,000 students. Our programs have resulted in an average increase of their household incomes by about 150%. Nisha now works in a startup in Gurgaon. Meenakshi now works in a large tech company. And there are so many entrepreneurs, graphic designers, musicians that we've seen over the last 4 or 5 years who had been waiting for someone to come help them navigate through their career choices. It's been a fantastic, fantastic journey for all of us. We understand how important it is to train our students to be self-starters. They do not need to be told what to do anymore. Our classrooms really need to adapt to the changing needs of today's careers. As educators, we owe a solution to our students who are still signing up every day believing careers is a result of education. As a student who could not derive a lot of value from, you know, our higher education system, I completely understand that our education system is going through a massive user experience problem. And suddenly, you know, for me, my report card doesn't really worry me, but it's the tiny impact on 13,000 lives that we've had over the last 4 years, which is all that matters for us. Thank you.